Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's Fallout Friday. I haven't said that in a little while. So we are back at Egret Tours Marina again, and we're going to work on converting the boathouse here into an armory and quarters for the commanding officer. So as always, if you like what you see, do hit that big red button, and let's get stuck in. So this could end up being a little fast-paced, but we'll see how we get on. I've cleared everything out, got rid of all the crap, but scrap that settlement to good use. You see the doors at either end are stuck in the position they're in. That one that's closed won't open, and this one at the end won't close either. So we'll attend to that in a bit. Using a warehouse floor here, warehouse foundation rather, and we'll actually pull this out in a moment, but need a foundation piece to get the height of the floor right. So we want floor pieces to sit over the existing floor, but be as low as possible whilst sort of concealing it at the same time. So we'll line this up. That's a little too low. Just nudge it up a little bit. That should be about right. It actually sits pretty snugly up to the edge of the wall there, which is good. Unfortunately, I couldn't use foundation pieces all the way through, but the floor pieces work just fine anyway. There we go. And it means the transition between the edges of the floor pieces and the existing floor is a little more subtle as well. So unfortunately, once again, the building's a slightly weird shape and size, so it doesn't quite fit. I did this a while back on a different save. So one of my earliest decent builds actually was here. But I can't for the life of me remember how I actually got the floor to work. So I had to kind of figure it out all again. What we got there? You can see we're having a bit of trouble getting a few pieces in there. My solution, for the most part, was this. So stick some small pieces down. It won't unfortunately go all the way up to the wall there. But that's easily dealt with. Once we've got something else to snap to, the half-size pieces go in just fine. Just like that. So make sure we get them the right way around, and it'll look exactly the same anyway. Which that's not. There we go. So I'll pull these single pieces out, because they look a little strange next to the larger ones. Yeah, much neater. And most of the floor is very forgiving with this. See, that went in nice and easily. Fortunately, it clips through a little bit, but we can't have everything. So this one, however, was a problem. For some reason, that post did not want to play ball, and I couldn't get it to work. And as we can't sink the pillar into it, that didn't work either. See, I did attempt to just use select all and go through the one part of the floor that you actually can sink into. But no joy. So this is the one place in this build that you have to resort to using Swapper. But that went very well as well, so it's quite quick and easy, and just dropped in neat as you like. Can't even tell it was not snapped in, really. There we go. Just get it nice and lined up. Make sure we've got the height right, which is a bit of guesswork, really. Try not to make it go invisible. There we go. So obviously it won't sit snugly to that wall. Simplest solution is just to stick an internal wall on there. Hindsight, I should probably not have bothered with the door, but I kind of like the way of end up putting two doors in there. Sort of one on each side that open in opposite directions, and utterly pointless, it works quite well. There's a sort of random piece. And these warehouse pieces are a little lower than the level of the boathouse actually is. So you see the floors touch the roof rather than the sort of internal walls. So unfortunately it's not going to snap on there, but a little bit of select all and adjustment to make sure we get the height right, and it goes in nice and easily. Very forgiving as always. Simple as. There is actually a bit of a gap there, but you can't really tell. And once we've got the upper floor in, can't tell at all. So I wanted to tidy this door up a bit because it's going to be the front edge and it's exposed beyond where the eventual wall around the around this part of the settlement anyway is going to be. And there's a rather large hole at the top there. Unfortunately, because we're moving a door piece over a door piece, it doesn't quite match up. So there's a lot of fiddling around to get this in place. See, two door frames there, it looks awful. And for some reason, it didn't want to play ball on this side, even after I pulled the floor out. But we'll get there. We'll go across and try it from that side, and for some reason it works much better there, eventually. I've got a lot of minute adjustment and fiddling around with it. It's still not perfect, but it's better than it was. And of course, floor goes back in nice and easy, which is brilliant. So I took these doors off, because I'm going to block this hole up, and I figured they might well get in the way. I don't recall them getting in the way last time I did this, but I don't have to take the risk, so why would I? Again, just a standard warehouse wall, select all with a concrete pillar, and in it goes nice and neat. Just line it up with the floor and the wall. And the end result's really smooth, I quite like it. Same thing again on the other side, sadly it won't snap again, but select tools nice and easy. Half wall at the top, just plug the remaining gap. Just line up the braces there so it looks like it was as close as we can get to looking like it was always there. Look at that. Neat as you like. So as this is going to be an armory on this floor, you don't really want big exposed windows. And they look rubbish anyway. So we're going to cover them over with more wall pieces. It's a bit of a theme for this build. It's plugging in gaps and reinforcing the structure, so it's a lot of select all, a lot of fiddling to get it right. Unfortunately, because the window frame sticks out a little bit, you have to accept a certain amount of clipping, but I should have that reasonably concealed next time. Unfortunately, they don't quite line up, because the roof's awkward, basically. But that'll do fine anyway. And with the best will in the world, this building is always going to look ramshackle anyway, so we can live with a little bit of a oddness on the lines there. So my first attempt here was just to snap the floor straight in, which it does quite nicely on the walls I've put in underneath. But that doesn't put it anywhere close to level with the rest of the floor. And trying to stack it up probably wouldn't have led to it being the right height either. So went for a similar technique to the one I used on Spectacle Island. I did the upper floor on the main house there, which is select all, carefully position the first one in, and snap to it. So quite a lot of fiddling, and the Egret Tours have been a pain here again on the floor. There's only certain places you can sink in. I don't know why, but I'm pretty sure it was doing that before I used mods. So. Despite being one of my favourite places to build, it is challenging at times. So we've got a couple of pillars, check the height, nowhere near there. Make an adjustment, try again. It's a lot of fiddling and adjusting to get this right, but once you get the first one in correctly, it will all snap together nice and easily. So. It's just what we want. By heading upstairs, we get a better line on whether or not the thing's straight as well, because we're much closer to it. And despite the fact I can't see the bottom of the pillar, for some reason it wants to work just fine, so great, we'll roll with that. What I'm doing here is lining up the short edge with the existing floor. So you try and use the long edge and the wall, find the game's nightmare with its perspective will completely throw you off, and even doing it this way took a lot of fiddling. It took me about half an hour just to get this straight, which it needn't really have done, but I was fussy, so it's still not quite right there either. But useful little trick, take that section of floor out and you can just select all and take it right back out again. But obviously if you leave the floor there, you'll end up selecting everything you've already put in. So we'll put the floor back and try again, and after much fiddling we get it right. So We'll snap the floors in nice and easily. As you can see, there's a bit of a gap. Sadly, I can't scrap that walkway along the right there. But we'll just make do with the fact there's a hole there. I'll be putting a carpet in up here later on, so it doesn't matter too much. As you may have noticed just there, the floor actually snapped through the wall briefly, which is very handy and worth remembering for later on, because we will come back to that. So, plugging up the gaps upstairs, the warehouse pieces are too big. This is the corrugated steel wall piece from the wood tab, and it's exactly the right height, so use the lamppost so it snaps to the floor, select all, and straight in, just like that. Which you then repeat on two of the windows on the other side. I also use the same principle to create door frames, which I'll show you in just a moment. Sort of, anyway. These doors, it's always worth coming out and checking you've got them the right way around, so you know they're opening the way you want them to, which we have got now. These are actually warehouse doors from the warehouse tab, and they're very cooperative because you can just slap them down without needing a frame, whereas most doors you'll need to put a frame in first, which I'll show you in just a moment. There we go, you see I've plugged up the sides of the hole to give them a smooth edge. Just used a sort of curved corrugated metal wall ends, they're added by unlocked settlement objects. Really for use in the steel tab, but they work very well here. So again, it's just select all, slide those in as well. Done the same thing in the other corner here already. And there we go. Door's in place. Have a quick look at what the building looks like so far. And we'll start looking at some internal walls. So yeah, you can see those half-wall pieces there in the half-walls tab, funnily enough. But this is one of the vanilla items. But it matches up with the wall much more neatly. Well, mostly anyway. It's not very square, but what can you do? Select all, drop that one in as well. I did say it was a theme. And although it doesn't look too neat there, the finished product, it looks absolutely fine. And we'll repeat the same procedure downstairs on that extra wall we put inside, just to plug off the end. It doesn't go all the way up, but it doesn't really matter. Looks just fine anyway. So that is the main building basically repaired. See that floor on upstairs as well. Quick look around. Now, this is going to be the commanding officer's office and living quarters. So we divide the space in half. So at this stage, the wall piece is hitting those beams, but scrap that settlement, let's just take those out. And then you could probably select all and get around that if you haven't got scrap that settlement. Seem to remember I did something similar in the past. In this instance, that one went in just fine once I took those off, which snapped right into place. This again is similar to something I did at Spectacle Island. On the ground floor there, I put a wall and a door in place. And it's basically the same technique, but a little harder, because I had a flat ceiling to work with there, and this one isn't. But we'll line it up with the floor pieces. It's a little bit of fiddling, but easy enough, really. There we go. A little bit wonky. Straighten it off. Yeah. If it doesn't want to play ball, just try looking at a different part of the object. For some reason it works better. You definitely need to be able to see the bottom, but sometimes it's that bottom corner. So, for internal doors without a door frame, this is the technique we use. As I say, some of them will just go in just absolutely fine, but this one won't do it. So we'll take it out the door frame, select all, move it somewhere flat-ish. Which is particularly challenging at Egret Tours, but if you've got flat ground to work with, it's much easier, especially if you can sink into it. Which this corner works, but the rest of this end is a bit more temperamental, so. And after that, use the lamppost again, select all, and there we go again. Now, at this stage, I completely forgot which way around the door was and which way it was going to open, so this will be scratching my head and trying to figure it out. So run out and checked. So it's much easier to do it there. Well, just press cancel and let it drop back than to find out I've done it wrong when after I've put it in. So then I'd have to start from scratch again. But we're absolutely fine. So it just slides in between the two walls like that. It's ever so slightly too narrow, but that actually makes it look better. As long as you don't overdo it. Anyway. So we're just going to plug the gap. So this is a bit that's really like Spectacle Island. It's just yet more select all, moving in various half wall pieces and railings from the wood tab, balcony railings. Those are very good for this particular job. It's never going to look particularly neat, no matter how hard you try, unfortunately. And it was a choice between a slightly scruffy wall or leaving the gap there, and I wasn't happy with that. So, onto the railing pieces now, to stop running into walls. You see, it just looks like they've nailed on some wood to the top of it, which does the job. It actually ends up looking much neater once I've decorated the place, which I have no idea why, because I didn't actually change it or anything after this, but for some reason it just worked. As the great Todd Howard would say. So get this last one into place. And look at it from the other side. Oh, it's planks of wood nailed in the place, but it plugs up the gap. Because I'm not going to put anything on the roof. It doesn't really matter if it sticks through a tiny bit. Although to be fair, I don't think it does much. And speaking of the roof, I did have a look into fixing it, but I'm just going to have to live with the holes in the roof, because unfortunately there's nothing going to sit over the top of it. Not without looking awful anyway. So, the armory needs fencing off now. And security fences are added by unlocked settlement objects as well. They're under fences and then security. And they turn yellow, so once you've got them in place, there's not much you can do with them apart from start again if you need to adjust them. However, the rug glitch nice and easily, so if you've got them on the rug, especially if you're using these invisible ones, you can just leave the rug there and you can come back and adjust them at your leisure. And that one fits in very nicely. This one, however, doesn't. So we'll get the large one into place. To be honest, I think I ended up swapping this around and using a different piece in the end. So I wanted a window for somebody to stand in. You'll see that in the tour in a minute. And we just position it in, light it all up, which is really quite awkward to be fair. Which is another good reason to use rug glitch for this, because you can come back and adjust it when it's inevitably not straight. Like that. So there's, I do apologise for the darkness here by the way, that's a half size piece for the same thing. I'll just plug the gap with that. And there we go. So we're onto the tour. As you can see, I've put a balcony on the top floor there. And as I mentioned before, the floor pieces just snap straight onto the floor we've put on inside. So it goes straight through the wall and sticks out nice and neat. And you just put the balcony together very, very easily. And after that, it's just putting some railings on. The other wall looks nice and neat there. Shack bridges are the same ones we used to shore up the floor of the bar on the other side. That's an interesting little point, I should say, by the way, as well. I attached a bathroom onto the corner, which is relatively simple. Similar to the balcony, just put a floor down and then snap to it. Or use select all again in places as well. Those doors were the same technique we used upstairs for the balcony doors, because unfortunately they don't snap to these pieces. And we have our armory. There's little tables there. Unlock settlement objects again there. Cafe tables, but they're exactly the right height to use with vendor rugs, so I've got a couple of an armour and a weapons merchant standing on them effectively, just to look like they're manning the place. So Minutemen aren't big on power armour, but I figure it's after they've beaten the Institute and so on, so and the Brotherhood as well, so there's power armour available to them. So that's a suit of T60 for the commanding officer. And we've got a line of T-45s here for a few of the other Minutemen to use. Oh, with Minutemen paint on these as well. No Minutemen paint available for the T-60s, so that's just military paint. These are not actually put on using OC Decorator. Unacceptable objects provides us with equipment clutter, so it works in much the same way, but that's where those come from. Some weapon racks and the necessary workbenches. Ammunition storage. Apparently I haven't put the rug down just yet, but there will be a vendor rug there. But a couple of switches that don't actually do anything, they're for decoration to buzz people in and out of the secured area. This little corridor section, I wanted to leave the existing shelving in, but I had no idea what to do with it, so I haven't done anything with it. If I come up with an idea, or I'll get some good suggestions, hint hint, then we'll put something on there, but as I won't be able to use OC Decorator for anything other than the top shelf, I'm not so sure it's going to work very well. That's the set of two doors back to back that I mentioned earlier. So one opens inwards, one opens outwards, and it's a strange sort of almost airlock type thing to get in there. Not that there's any room to stand between them. And we have the CO's office. This carpet works exactly the same as a rug, just stops right into the corner and then just stick the squares next to it. And suddenly the holes in the floor are all gone. That coat rack is going, by the way. It's sadly not a static object, and it's a bit of a nightmare. I don't know why I put it in the first place, really. So some display cases. That radio there is tuned to Radio Freedom. We've got it on just at the moment. X01 head in the display case. Once again, OC Decorator put the books and stuff on, but they won't fit on those bookshelves, the wooden ones. You have to use the metal ones. They're just too large for it. So it's rather minimalist. That's why this one hasn't got any on. It's extremely frustrating to try and put overdue books on there one by one as well. A few paintings, a few nice bits and pieces. This is by far and away the nicest living space. Napoleon looking suspiciously like Todd Howard. And the bathroom. Let's say carefully position that floor into place. And after that, most of the walls snapped in, apart from this one we're looking at now, which just had to be selected and slid in with the lamppost. And then left a tiny little bit of exposed space on the corner there, but the tall thin pieces that snap on there just went straight on, no problem. You see, that wall looks a lot neater now for some reason. No idea why, it just does. So out onto the balcony. Now there's not much going on up here, apart from this settler if some reason wants to hang around here. So we've got a little bit of a seating area and some sandbags and stuff down at the end for a bit of variety, because you can double up as a extra defensive position. So you see out over the front there. Gives them somewhere else to shoot from if they need to. Although by the time I finish with this, you'd have to be crazy to attack it. But then raiders generally are crazy, so. We'll have a quick look outside. Everything I've got out here is temporary. It's just goes to needing to feed the settlers now they're starting to arrive. I will put the farm back here, I think, because it's out of the way, and otherwise it's dead space. You may have glimpsed the water purifier behind us there. That's a no-respawns trick. Just set it down in the water and then use a concrete pillar and select all, and you can move it onto dry land. Which works very well. There you go, you see in the corner. So let's have a look at this place in the night. And there we go. Some spotlights out there, surveying the concourse there. I'll be shifty round. Used fluorescent lighting in here, and I really like the effect it's got. It's got a slight yellow colour to it. It just works. I keep saying it. With the shadows and the way it highlights, I really like it. Got a few spotlights on the weapons on the wall there. But all in all, it creates a very secure armoury sort of a feel. Well, I think it does anyway. A little bit of AC decorator around. The power armour looks great. I do like these high-tech power armour stations. They're too close to the wall to be actually usable, but they do look good. Some paint in the corner there. I guess they've been working on their CO's T60. Take a shuffle upstairs. There we go. There's standard light bulbs in here, but because of the size of the space, it does look quite cosy with them. I think the carpet probably has something to do with that as well. I'm trying to remember which way the door opens. Not as well lit in here, but it is a bedroom after all. And there we go, a little bathroom. So, slightly repetitive on the building side of things, but it's worth seeing. Should you want to do something similar yourself, you should be able to. I've got to get rid of that coat rack. So, I hope you enjoyed that. We should have another video up next week, and I think we're going to be working on the walls there. And there will be a small settlement out front eventually, I think. But, as always, thank you very much for watching. If you'd like to, you can find me on social media, Facebook and Twitter, at @DarthZionGames. If you want to hear me rant about the various things that are frustrating me at the moment, and ramble about the channel and stuff. Thank you very much for watching. Do hit those wonderful buttons, and I will speak to you soon.